Hi all, electrical engineer with you, Igor Ekimov. Today we will look at the FNIRSI WD-01 detector. I have already encountered a dozen different detectors at sites, so the information in this video will be as practical as possible. The FNIRSI WD-01 detector is designed to search for metals, wood and live wiring. I have already tested this device and came to the conclusion that its parameters are very similar to the DMF-10 zoom detector from Bosch, but it has much smaller dimensions. Plus, I bought the Bosch detector for $100, and the detector from FNIRSI costs 3 times less. I left a link to the device in the description. I will be reviewing other devices on the channel. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss these reviews. Please support this video by liking and reposting. Let's look at the declared characteristics of the device. Search for magnetic metals 12 cm, search for non-magnetic metals 10 cm, search for live wiring, up to 4 cm, search for wood, up to 4 cm. We will figure out how much this device corresponds to the declared characteristics during the video. Let's take a look at the device itself. This is a small device. The case is well made to inspire confidence in the device itself. There is a film applied to the front panel, which I will not remove for now. The packaging is also good, increasing confidence in the device. The kit includes instructions in English and Chinese. The branded carrying case is convenient and allows you to attach it to your belt. And the charging cord is Type-C on one side and USB on the other. The device itself has a power button to turn on the device. There is also a speaker and the Type-C charging input itself. On the back side there are velvety linings that prevent you from scratching the walls when using the device. There is a sensor in the middle. Using a pencil, you can mark the location identified by the sensor. Let's turn on the device. The screen is backlit. The charge level is displayed in the upper left corner. The material is displayed in the middle. In this case, searching for iron. Distance to material. The zoom level is shown on the right as a percentage. A centering scale appears at the bottom when we have already found the object. There are 3 indicators around the sensor. The indicator lights up green when it is far from the object. As you approach, the orange indicator lights up. When close, the red indicator lights up. With this button we can choose whether we are looking for metal or wiring. Or we can search for wood by clicking on this button. By holding down the buttons at the same time, we can turn on the sound signal. As you can see, a speaker has appeared. We press the buttons together again, the signal turns off. The device turns off automatically if it is not used for more than 5 minutes. Let's start with the function it does best. This is metal detecting. Detection stated at a depth of 12 centimeters. In reality, it depends on the dimensions of the metal we are looking for. If we are talking about large reinforcement, this distance is 12 centimeters. If we look for a coin, it will be 5 centimeters. And he will find a paperclip from 2 centimeters. We turn on metal detecting. If the device has found magnetic material, a magnet is displayed here. If he found a non-magnetic material, then a crossed-out magnet is displayed here. If nothing is displayed, then the device was unable to determine the type of metal. When is this feature needed? When we install a chandelier on drywall. It is better to attach it to iron profiles, since the fastening will be more reliable. And if you install precision lamps, then you should make sure that there are no iron profiles installed together. Otherwise, it will make installation difficult. And sometimes some electricians cut profiles when they get hit. As a result, the drywall structure is weakened. Also, when drilling holes in the wall, you should make sure that you do not hit the fittings. Otherwise, it will bring you a lot of unnecessary problems. There is another application. If you have the opportunity to adjust the installation location of the socket and switch, then you can check at the installation site for the absence of fittings. And only then make holes for the socket box. This will help you save time. without having to cut out the fittings from the installation side of the socket box. I used this function in similar detectors all the time. And I took the Bosch detector shown earlier with me for these purposes. This detector also copes well with this function. As you can see, since I did not use the device for a long time, it turned off. Let's turn it on again. Let's get into practice. To improve search accuracy, it is necessary to calibrate the device. To do this, move the device away from the wall and hold the button. We wait until the green indicator turns off. When it turns on, the device is ready for use. When you have calibrated the device, do not change the position of the device in your hand, and do not transfer it to the other hand, since the position of your hand also affects the calibration of the device. This applies to all operating modes of the device. Let's take a ruler. First, let's look for it on the table. As you can see, the device finds it easily. Here the alignment scale appears. We carry it out. Interest rates are decreasing. Let's go back. The device finds her again. Again the scale decreases. Now let's put the ruler under the table. Let's try to find her. My tabletop is about 3 centimeters. Here is the alignment scale. Now it appears that this is a magnetic material, that it is 3 centimeters from the ruler. Please note that what lights up is that there is electrical wiring here too, which in reality is not there. But we'll talk about this a little later. He finds iron quite well. Let's turn the device and see how it finds the ruler. That is, the turned device also finds iron well. Just for fun, let's look for another coin. Well, the detector finds the coin well. Here we clean it up. Here, as you go up, the scale gets smaller. We get closer to the coin, the scale gets bigger. An interesting phenomenon. When we get very close to the coin, the distance in centimeters disappears. When we take the device away, centimeters appear again. Here the detector finds a coin at a distance of about 8 centimeters, then the device does not see it. Please note that you can switch the modes of searching for wiring and searching for metal, with this button. Searching for wiring, searching for metal. As I said, I mainly use this function at sites. To search for reinforcement and search for metal profiles. The next function that can be used in the device is tree search. It should be noted that this can be not only a tree. In this mode, the device searches for inhomogeneities in the wall. He can find a plastic pipe and a void. When searching for wooden beams in a plasterboard wall, you should place the device parallel to them. Otherwise, he identifies them poorly. I noticed this feature specifically in this device. What is this for? Again, as with metal detecting, we need to look for wooden beams to attach to. And avoid them if we want to install hidden sockets. It's no secret that heavy objects need to be attached to the beams. Drywall or lining may not support heavy objects. Let's practice. Turn on tree search mode. There is a precise search mode. If we hold the button for a long time, the deep search mode is activated. Let's look for this pencil. We raise. We lead. As you can see, the device found a pencil. Let's move on. He stops seeing him. Let's go back. Please note that if we point perpendicular to the pencil, the device does not see it. As I said, the device must be held parallel to the bars that we are looking for. This device can detect not only wooden beams. Let's calibrate the device. There are metal, plastic and polypropylene pipes with water. We are looking. I found a pipe. The scale dropped a little. I found some metal plastic pipes. Again the scale fell. I found the following polypropylene pipe. Now let's try to search in this position. Actually found it. It turns out that he is looking for plastic pipes in this position. It is better to look for wooden beams by placing the device along the beams. And the last function is to search for wiring. It is turned on by this button. I want to say that with this device and similar devices, wiring can be found in 50% of cases. This is a feature of the operation of this and similar devices. This also applies to this Bosch device. All space is now permeated with fields that the device senses. It is especially difficult to look for wiring when the walls are damp, and there are fittings in them that can carry small currents. Calibrating the device does not always help. It is better to look for wiring when current flows through it. If you go to a site, you shouldn't trust the device to accurately find the wiring. Devices that have their own signal generators work better. An inexpensive example would be a hidden wiring finder. It has its own signal generator, which generates a frequency different from the 50 Hz network. This way, you can separate the background of the wire from the surrounding background. And it is the seeker himself who determines this background. It can also detect 50 Hz background. Even without a generator, it works more efficiently, because it shows the actual AC background in its speaker or headphones, allowing you to more accurately locate the wire. If you wish, I can make a separate video on this wiring finder. Write in the comments how relevant it is for you. We will look for wiring using this device. First, let's calibrate, and we operate this device. Here the wire goes from bottom to top and the detector sees it. As you can see, the wire is somewhere here. Please note that there is a dry wall here and there is no reinforcement. Therefore, the device copes relatively easily. But this does not always happen, and the device rings almost everywhere, indicating that the wiring supposedly runs along the entire area of the wall. Let's draw conclusions. This device is well suited. If we want to look for metal or wooden beams behind drywall or clapboard, and finding electrical wiring is an additional feature that may or may not work. For me, I see this detector as an alternative to my Bosch detector. I like that it has a built-in battery, no need to spend money on crown batteries. Indicating the depth of the material will also be useful. And it's much smaller, so it saves space in your toolbox and fits more comfortably on your belt. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. You can also ask the manufacturer. I left a link to the manufacturer's website in the description. Subscribe to the channel if such videos interest you. Support the video with a like. Share with your friends. Please support the channel financially. This will help him survive in this difficult time. See you in new and old videos.